In part two of this two-part series, I'll show you how to embed an RTSP camera into a website or create a link that anyone can click. And we're starting right now. Hi, I'm Orman Beckles, aka The High Tech Nomad, and welcome to another video. On this channel, you'll find videos covering the basics as well as tips and tricks on cell phones, computers, smart home devices, social media, apps, hardware, and more. So, if you want to learn how to make technology work for you, start now by pressing the subscribe button and be sure to click the bell icon so you don't miss a video. Now, in part one of this series, I showed you how to convert a $35 Wyze camera into an RTSP, a real-time streaming protocol camera. And I've seen a lot of videos on YouTube trying to deal with how you take an RTSP camera and turn it into a web link. And I guarantee you, I have the easiest way for you to do that, to embed it either in your website or to create a link. And I believe it's about three clicks. So let's pick up where we left off. We've rebooted the camera. We're back into the app itself. The camera should still work normally in the Wyze app. Let's go to settings. And if we scroll down to the bottom and go to advanced settings and scroll down to the bottom again, we now have a new menu item called RTSP. We're going to go ahead and click on that. We're going to turn it on. And when we turn it on, it's going to ask us for a username and a password. Now, this is just for this camera, for the RTSP URL. This will make more sense in a minute. But basically, you want to come up with a username and a password. Doesn't need to be anything fancy, and it shouldn't be something that you've used someplace else. I just called mine LiveCam, and I called it Pass for Password. It must be a minimum of 4 characters, a maximum of 8, I believe. Just put something in. For the purposes of this tutorial, I'm going to leave it at live cam and pass so that you can see it. I'm going to go ahead and click on generate URL. And now we have RTSP live cam at 192.168.1.39. Now yours is going to look different because what it's going to do is it's going to assign it an IP that you already have in your own system. Everybody's system's different, but essentially it'll be something like 192.168.1.something or 192.168.0.something or 10.1.10.1.something or 10.0.0.1. Those are the most common ones. You'll see something like this. Now we need this. We're going to need this URL. Either write it down or copy it. I'm going to go ahead and copy it. Now it is in the copy buffer. Now, you don't have to do this next step, but if you want to just make sure that you're all set up until this point, you can download a program called VLC. I'll put a link for this down below. You download VLC. You open VLC. You click on Media. You click on Network Stream. Paste that URL that you had, hit play, and if everything's working all right, you're on the same. Once you do that, you'll be able to see that stream. Now, for some people, this is all they need. They're like, okay, great. I can access this. And there's a number of programs that will just say, if you give me the RTSP URL, I'll be able to access it. So you can see now that this is within the house. As long as I'm within the house and I use this player, I can access this. Now we need to figure out how to use it outside of our house. I'm going to go to the main router in my house for the internet, which in my case is BIOS, and it's 192.168.1.1. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and click on it. Now, everybody's is going to look a little different. Now, essentially what this is the main access. This is the main modem into your house. And as the name implies, router, routing, saying you go here and you go there. That's what this does, this router. And what we're most interested in is something called port forwarding. Again, it'll be different on every system. If you know what the words are, you can look for them. We're looking for port forwarding. If you look right here, you'll see we have port forwarding. So I'm going to click on that. And the port that we have to worry about is 554. What most of you will do is we need to say that anything that needs to look at 554 should go to that particular camera. Some places you just go ahead and you put it in. You say it's 192.168.1.39. You can do it that way. Some of them let you pick from the list. So if I go down through this list and look through it, eventually we'll see that 39. Where is it? Oh, that's 239. Eventually we'll see it. I know it says a Wyze camera, so I think it'll just be in here somewhere. There's a couple. You can see I have quite a few Wyze cameras, and here's one here. That's the 192.168.1. So I'm going to click on that. And then it says which application. It has some different applications, but we're going to say ports. And it says, which port do you want me to forward? And we're going to say 554. And then we're going to click add. And so that means anything that comes to our house looking for port 554, it is going to be sent to the camera, 192.168.1.39. Now we need to find the number that's outside. It's called the public IP. I use a service called IP Chicken. That is the number that you need to retain for outside of your house. All right. That's the number to my house. Now we know the number to my house, and we know which port we need to use, which is 554. We need to take that link that we had earlier, and we need to change it to match this. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to take this, and we're going to take that number from the IP chicken. I'm going to change it here for this, just for the sake of discussion. So I'm going to say 100, 200, 100, 50, colon, 554. That's what you need to do. So now it knows this is the main number to the house. That's the port that's almost always used by RTSP anyways. This is the username. That's the password. All right. We're going to go to a really great service called RTSP.me. RTSP.me. And this is how we're going to change it to a URL that anybody can use. It's a free service. They do have some paid tiers. I do encourage you to take a look at them. Let's see, here's so the free one will work just fine. It will require that the person click on the play button for it to start. If you want it to autoplay, they ask for $9 a month, which is more than reasonable. But you can do this just with the free service. It will require your users to click the play button before it starts. Here it has right here, it says, okay, give me your RTSP link. That's that link we just made. Okay. Put the link in, and it says, give me your email address and your data center. Now, the data center should be the closest one to you. So in my case, I'm going to pick Miami. Once you hit create and sign up, it will give you an instant acknowledgement that it works, as you can see, that it's in there and works. And although they'll email us this information, they're going to give us both the what's called the iframe information as well as a link. I'm going to come over to another tab, an empty tab. I'm going to paste in that link, and Bob's your uncle. There it is. So you can actually just give somebody that link, and if they click on that link, they'll be able to see your live stream. We also have what's called the iframe. This is what we're going to put into our web page. So at this point, that's easy enough to do. Let's go ahead and hit copy. And let's go to our website creation tool. I'm using Wix, and I'm going to click on add, and I'm going to look for HTML somewhere in here. It'll say add an HTML. Let's see. Oh, embed is fine. I can live with that. So I'm going to click on embed, and you'll see it says embedded widget, embed a site, custom element. We're going to say widget. And basically what it's saying is, give me the code. What code do you have? So I'm going to go ahead and click on enter code. And all I have to do is paste that code that we just had. That's all. Then I'll click update. And that's it. We now have, there it is. We now have a live stream that's embedded in our website. We can just go ahead and click save, and it'll go ahead and save that. Congratulations, you now have a streaming webcam as either a link or as part of your website. Now, you can move this camera wherever you want. The only thing you have to remember is that you have to adjust the modem. Now, I started this one at my house. I'll be moving it to an office building in Boston, and I'll have to reconfigure the modem just as we just did to allow port 554 to access the camera. Now, webcams, as I said, can be a lot of fun. In part one, I told you about how I ran one for several years and made some terrific friends. People visiting Boston from all over the world would come to my house and stand out in front just so they could wave hello to family and friends back home. I think the most incredible moment that ever happened was when someone took a screen capture of me playing with my son in our living room at the exact same time as my wife was taking a picture. In the comments below, tell me about your live streaming project, what you've done in the past, and what you're planning on doing in the future. Now, if you found this video helpful, please click the like button. And for more videos like this, please click the subscribe button. Now, if you found this video super helpful and want to access exclusive content, please consider becoming a member. It costs less than the price of a cup of coffee, and it helps keep this channel going. Until the next time, this is Orman Beckles, aka The High Tech Nomad, signing out. I'd like to say a big thank you to all of the supporters who have become members. You ensure that this channel continues to exist, and I am profoundly grateful for all of your support. If you become a member, you'll get instant access to extra video content, as well as bonus links, access to live streams, and more. Becoming a member per month costs about the same as a large cup of coffee, so why not check it out?